is now entering its final phase of the investigative process, which are the public hearings. You will recall that the health market inquiry was initiated in 2014 under the provisions of Chapter 4, capital letter A of the Competition Act of 1990. Briefly, a market inquiry, for the benefit of those who have not been part of this process, is no more than a formal inquiry in respect of the general state of competition into a particular sector. And experts in these areas have described market inquiry as being essentially research projects which are intended to gain in-depth understanding of how sectors, markets, or market practices are working. The purpose of the exercise is essentially to determine whether the process of competition in these sectors is working well or whether it can be improved. And these inquiries, of course, provide a framework for identifying, analyzing, and where appropriate, remedying sector-wide and market-wide competition problems. And what I need to emphasize, and this is a point that I have emphasized about this process, is that the nature of this inquiry is fundamentally investigative in its nature. No one is accused of having committed any conduct that is anti-competitive. The focus is how the markets in the private healthcare sector as a whole function. However, the process, as is required by the law, must be conducted in accordance with the principles of fairness. Essentially, what the Act does is it empowers the Competition Commission to conduct a market inquiry, perhaps in two situations. The first is if it has reasons to believe that any feature or combination of features of the market for goods or services prevents, distorts, or restricts competition. Secondly, it can also conduct a market inquiry in order to achieve any of the listed purposes of the Act. The market inquiry, of course, is generally triggered by concerns about the functioning of the market or the markets. And of course, these concerns may arise from the behavior of firms, market structure, lack of information, consumer conduct, or public sector intervention by way of policies. Let me just say very briefly where we are with the process of investigation so that you can get a sense of where we're going and how far are we from the end. The health market inquiry has been in operation, as you might be aware, since early 2014, and has accomplished many of its key milestones in a long and very complex process. We have recently published a revised statement of issues which discusses the major elements of the work to date and provides some indications of the issues that the stakeholders have raised through their various interactions with us. The market inquiry is presently in the investigative phase, which is concerned with gathering evidence on possible impact of market structure and the conduct of market players on competition in the private healthcare sector. This investigating phase further involves the refinement of focus areas, the identification, collection, and analysis of data and information, the formulation of provisional conclusions on data and information collected, and the preparation of position papers on specific key issues. This phase will also guide the request for any additional information and clarity that the market inquiry requires as it enters the public hearing phase. In the administrative phase which preceded the investigating phase, the market inquiry received some 6 to 8 initial written submissions from stakeholders totaling to some 15,000 pages. Where there were no issues of confidentiality, these were published on our website for each and every one of you to have a look at those and to assess the accuracy or otherwise of the information that's contained there. Certain submissions, as you would have noticed, attributed the cost increases to market power in 3 groups of stakeholders: hospital groups, medical schemes and their respective administrators, and specialist medical practitioners. Insofar as market power is concerned, the views tend to vary largely in relation to the stakeholders' location within the market. A number of submissions have also raised concerns about the regulatory environment. Some have submitted that there is a lack of regulation or adequate enforcement of applicable regulations due to ineffective oversight by the regulatory bodies. Others have submitted that there is over-regulation in certain areas, resulting in barriers to entry, expansion, and innovation in the private healthcare sector. Certain submissions argue that the regulation gaps remaining after the introduction of social solidarity principles to the funding side of the system have had adverse consequences on cost as well as negative effects on the vulnerable people who depend on the private healthcare sector. They argue that the elimination of the regulatory step will improve market outcomes with positive effect. Yet a number of submissions raise concern about the lack of information which is available to patients, highlighting the general lack of transparency in accessing private healthcare information, in particular from pricing, cost, and the quality of services. They have submitted this lack of information places patients at a disadvantage when making decisions on services, and that this disadvantage has huge implications for competition. What the health market inquiry seeks to understand is the interrelationship between the various markets and the private healthcare sector, including the contractual relationships and interactions between and within the health services providers, the influence they have on the dynamics and the functioning of the markets, the nature of competition, and within and between these markets, and the ways in which competition can be improved. The health market inquiry also wishes to assess the impact of the Competition Commission's interventions in the private healthcare through enforcement action and major regulation, including any possible impact this has had on prices, bargaining mechanisms, consolidation and competition in the healthcare sector. All this explains why the health market inquiry has embarked on extensive stakeholder engagement in order to determine more specifically the framework for the information gathering and analysis phases. This process guided the development of detailed information and data requests, which set the various categories and the nature of the information that the health market inquiry required to undertake the intended analysis. This engagement will continue throughout the remainder of the process. In the course of requesting information and data from the stakeholders, other stakeholders understandably sought some clarity on the request and the way the data that we requested from them had to be presented. And yet others also requested an extension of time within which to submit to us their data. It is the submission of the data and the request for extension of time that has somewhat delayed the finalization of our analysis, of our analytical phases, which is still ongoing at the moment. And also to understand the private sector in South Africa, as well as the relevant role players, we also conducted more general engagement with the wide range of stakeholders. We are currently finalizing a methodology paper which deals with market definition, as with the profitability analysis. Some stakeholders have provided us with their views, in particular how they define the various markets and their assessment of whether or not they have market power. The HMS is also in the process of finalizing our market definition methodology that will contribute to the determination of whether and where market power exists. The paper will be published shortly once it has been completed. And it is against this background that we are now entering the final phase of the head market inquiry, which is the public hearings. Of course, although I mentioned that this is the final phase, this must be understood, of course, as being subject to the need that may arise for a particular information to be obtained subsequently to fill in possible gap that may be identified for further engagement with particular stakeholders if the need should arise. The determination of the panel to conduct the inquiry fairly and in a transparent manner will not be compromised in this regard. Very broadly speaking, the primary purpose of public hearings is to afford the public, the stakeholders, policymakers, regulators, expert witnesses, as well as international experts, the opportunity to debate and provide insight into the healthcare market, how these markets operate, and to provide evidence, if any, of market failures. But at the same time, they provide the opportunity to test some of the assertions that have been made in the written submissions. In addition, where intervention is required, they provide the opportunity for understanding the impact of any proposed recommendations, in particular, the practical implications of proposed interventions, including understanding the extent, if any, to which similar interventions in other parts of the world have been successful in addressing competition challenges and lessons for South Africa from this experience. But what this process, public hearing, will also do, we hope, it will educate the public about how the private healthcare sector functions. This purpose is especially important with regard to the fact that access to healthcare services in our country is a fundamental right which is guaranteed by Section 27 of the Constitution. And more recently, this country has ratified the International Convention on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, which therefore means the right of access to healthcare is not just a constitutional obligation, but it is also an international obligation on our country. Now, you would have seen from the program which we have published on our website that there will be six sets of sessions of public hearing. The hearings will commence with a general session, which is intended to set the scene for hearing. And during this session and the following sessions making up the first set of hearing, we would like to hear from all stakeholders in the private healthcare sector, which includes the users of the system, consumers and consumer groups, service providers comprising of hospital groups and practitioners, funders and financiers, which include brokers, schemes, administrators, and managed care organizations and regulators as well as policymakers. The purpose of this session, which commences today and will run for the next 4 weeks, is to gain an understanding of how these groups interact with one another and their experience in interacting with one another. We hope that this session will enable the health market inquiry as well as the general public to get a better understanding of the nature of the private healthcare sector, how private healthcare sector services are provided and funded, and the regulatory framework for the private healthcare sector. The first set of this hearing commences today, and it will run up until the 10th of March. Due to limited resources, these hearings will only be held in Gauteng, KwaZulu-Natal, as well as in Cape Town. This session will then be followed by 5 more sets of public hearings. These will involve focused sessions, which focuses on specific aspects of competition issues, such as the availability of information about private healthcare services, competitive dynamics among funders, service providers, and the impact of regulatory framework on competition among sector stakeholders. These specific sessions will be conducted during the period which will commence on the 29th of March and will be completed on the 9th of June. The intention is that these hearings will be held on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays. There will, of course, be a break of about a week in between so as to give panel members the opportunity to synthesize the information presented in the preceding hearings and to prepare for the next hearings. The way these proceedings will be conducted is this. We have identified a team of evidence leaders which will assist with the examination of information that will be presented here. The team will also assist individuals who require assistance in the presentation of their submissions. And these proceedings will be conducted strictly in accordance with the guidelines that we have published on our website. These guidelines addresses a number of issues, including how one deals with confidentiality issues that might confidentiality of information that might arise from time to time. Indeed, one of the issues that appears to concern most of the stakeholders time and again is the protection of confidential information. The health market inquiry will adhere to the guidelines dealing with the presentation of confidential information at the hearing. In September, last year, we issued supplementary guideline number 2, which aims to address these concerns. The guidelines set out the framework for managing access to confidential information. In addition, the guidelines empower the chairperson to exclude from the hearings members of the public, specific persons, categories of persons from the hearings if the information to be presented is of a confidential nature. And the whole purpose is to protect the confidentiality of the information which that particular stakeholder might present or might wish to present before. Perhaps, by way of concluding, I do want to stress the point that I've made before, namely that this is essentially an investigative inquiry, which is intended to gain an understanding of how the private health sector functions. It is very informal, but yet it will be conducted strictly in accordance with the whole purpose of the exercise is to assess whether competition is functioning efficiently within the private healthcare sector and how we can improve efficiency within the private healthcare sector. But the promotion of competition is not an end in itself. One of the objectives of promoting competition is to provide consumers with competitive prices, product choices, and enhance access to healthcare services. This objective of competition law and policy must be understood in the light of the place of healthcare services in our country. And as I've pointed out before, Section 27 of the Constitution guarantees to everyone the right to have access to healthcare services. This constitutional right requires, among other things, that the state should facilitate access to healthcare services, regardless of who provides these services. Access is not just limited to physical accessibility premises that provide healthcare services, but it also includes affordability of healthcare services. To this extent, the Constitution requires the state to take reasonable legislative and other measures within its available resources in order to achieve the progressive realization of this constitutional right. It is therefore in the interest not just of competition law and policy that the private healthcare sector functions effectively and efficiently, but it's also in the public interest that the private healthcare market function in a way that promotes rather than undermines the purposes of the Act. With those few remarks, we are now going to commence with our proceedings. The first group that will present will be the technical team